Hello, this is Andy Schaefers at Maya, and today I'm going to be discussing a project I did using algorithmic modeling in NX, which automatically creates and places tabs for tab machining on a CAM workpiece. But because algorithmic modeling is new in NX 1953, and I think it's new to most of our customers, I'm going to start by introducing a couple of the tutorial parts for algorithmic modeling that Siemens provided. This first one here is a knurling feature. Here you see the algorithmic feature that's been created, and here are the inputs to that knurling command. Again, we're in algorithmic modeling. It just requires a face to map the knurl onto, and then a count in the U and V direction, and the distance is sort of the height of the diamonds. We're in millimeters here. So next, what's going on in the background that allows it to create this? We'll go into the resource library. That's where all these things live, and I'll edit the knurling algorithm so we can have a look. Here on the screen then laid out is this graphical representation where we create and then use the algorithm. You might recognize some of these things on the screen from the interface we just looked at. Here's our count in U and V, here's that face that we select, and here's the distance or the height of the knurl. Then that's being fed into something called a diamond cell, and the rest of this is just creating those diamonds and understanding where they need to be placed. At the very end, it uses that information to create a group of 3D surfaces, sews them together, and then outputs them as a single object. Now, it's not really accurate to say that this is just more powerful patterning, because typically in patterning in NX CAD, we would be creating the first instance of the knurl ourselves and then patterning around radially or linearly to create the rest of the instances. But in algorithmic modeling, the algorithm understands how to create that first and all subsequent instances of the pattern. So it truly is self-contained, and that gives it the capability to do more complex geometry and to really retain all of the inherent knowledge required to create that feature. Here's a second example of algorithmic modeling. We want to place a hose over this sketch. It prompts me here to select a curve. I've got 150 segments or divisions. It's going to use each diameter in this list of diameters, and when it runs out, it goes back to the beginning again. So I'm expecting it to alternate between 16 and 20 millimeters. Let's have a look. You can see that happening here. Now we'll click OK, and I'll demonstrate that this is a associative feature. So here's my sketch at the beginning, and I'll change this radius value to 100. So the sketch updates, and then the algorithmic feature updates. Now let's go back into it. We can make changes within the dialog box itself. And here I'll say 16, 16. So I want to make a sort of a coarser crimp. So I've got two 16s and three 20s. And we'll change this to 100. So just by making that change to the list, we've got a coarser shape on our tube. That's a quick overview of algorithmic modeling. Now I'm going to use it for my project where I wanted to create tabs for tab machining around the periphery of a part. And to begin, I used a composite curve, and what's significant here is I did turn on join curve so that the algorithm would see it as a single curve. Let's go into the reuse library and kick that off. The first thing here is to select that curve, and I'll change my pattern offset to 0%, and it does need an orientation. You can think of this, it's using the z-axis, which would probably relate to the normal vector for the top of the billet. Then I like these numbers, but let's change our stock side offset and direction to 0. And when we show result, we see the 10 tabs that are placed and oriented around the periphery. Now, as I look at this, I've got a couple of problems. Like, it's actually not coinciding here, intersecting the part. So that's the part side offset. I'll change that to 2 millimeters. And now it's going all the way in. But if I really want to stay away from those rounds, I'd use the Z direction offset and fix that. So now it's picked those up. But you can see it is correctly orienting that tab to the ramp here. Now, if I want to shift that pattern, that's this option right here. Actually, let's just do show results so you can kind of remember where those are. Then if I go to a 50% offset, then it's halfway from one to the previous position of the other one. Okay, I am going to change the coordinate system that I use just as an example so it's clear what that does. So here I'll deselect and reselect with this new coordinate system. And you can see it's still following the curve on the ramp. It's just that now that normal direction is off at an angle. Now that's probably not very useful in this case, but it just illustrates that you do have control over that orientation vector. The command also works on just a single curve that is not closed, and you can place one tab at a time if you really want full control of the positioning as you're working your way around. So, would this be useful to you? Get in touch with me if you'd like to give this a try. My understanding is that to use the algorithm, you need the algorithmic modeling license for NX. And if you want to create your own algorithms, that's Product Template Studio. But either get in touch with me or get in touch with your Maya account manager. They can get you set up with an evaluation license so you can give this a try. Thanks for watching today.